My wife died and she got what she deserved. You're like, what? Let me explain. My wife passed away about a month ago now from acute respiratory distress syndrome. And she'd been having a hard time the last few years with chronic pain and poor health. And her sister, they had kind of a family feud thing going where one of the sisters kind of didn't get along with the other three of them. And so what happened is my stepdaughter wrote the obituary and the one sister was not included in the obituary. And when she found out, she saw that, I guess she contacted my stepdaughter and said, "I'm done grieving for your mom. She got what she deserved." So it's kind of cold, although, you know, I do agree, my wife did get what she deserved. She's pain-free and in a better place. You know, she was suffering, and it's just all about how you look at it. I do videos about chronic pain all the time. I deal with chronic pain myself, so I actually do feel that it was better for her. You know, she's in a better place, she's out of pain, and you know, she can just be free and out of pain. I get comments all the time on my chronic pain videos. You know, I do videos sometimes about the prescription drugs and, you know, how hard it is on us chronic pain sufferers that, you know, we can't get, you know, the medication, the painkillers that we need. And people all the time say, you know, I'm just at the end of my rope. I think I'm going to end up killing myself and commit suicide. And, you know, this way, you know, she left. She died on her own. And there was times when she would get so down and depressed that when I left the house, I was always worried, am I going to come back and find out she took a whole bottle of pills or something like that? You know, it's like that was always kind of in the back of my mind. So really, yeah, I really miss my wife, but the more distance I get on this, the more I realize that, it was probably what was best for her. I don't think she was ready to die, but probably nobody really is yet. I mean, she was 55, so that's young. But, you know, when your body is giving out, you know, it's giving out. It doesn't matter. Like, my grandmother is in her 90s, but she doesn't really even know what's going on. She's just there. Someone has to be there, you know, 24/7 to take care of her. You know, she really, you know, she doesn't really recognize anyone, and she doesn't make any sense if she does talk. So I mean, I don't want to be like that. And you know, like for me, as long as I'm not productive anymore, I don't want to be around. I have, you know, thoracic outlet syndrome. You see the glove on my hand? It's because it's cold and I've been having all these circulation problems and my fingers turn white. And it's giving me all these problems. You know, I have, you know, chronic back pain and thoracic outlet syndrome. I've had pain since I was, you know, 20 years old. So I don't want to live to be old. When I really am not functional anymore, I just want to go. So I don't want to live to be old. I just want to live until I'm no longer functional. So an interesting thing is, several days after my wife passed away, this picture was sitting up on the shelf on the hutch, and we had birds. My stepson took the birds. That's why you don't hear birds chirping anymore, because he took the birds. But I was went to feed the birds, and the bird food was kind of down, sitting on the hutch. This was up a couple shelves above it and kind of off to the right. And when I went to get into the bird food, this picture was just sitting right on top of the bird food, just face up like that. And personally, I think it was my wife just letting me know that she's okay. I mean, I tried several times knocking the picture down, and it didn't even come close to landing in that position. It just fell on the floor. So, and there were several other things that I did see, like not long after she passed away, that I felt like it was her, you know, leaving signs like this, letting me know she's okay, don't worry about me, you know, just move on and do your thing. So doing my thing is making videos, and hopefully these videos will help a few people, and it kind of helps me just, you know, talking and venting and getting this stuff off of my chest. Thanks for watching, you guys, and I'll talk to you next time.
Well, time and fate can't be controlled. You play the hand that you dealt and the dice that you rolled. And who am I to question God anyway? Well, these days when I look back, I know I'm blessed to have been loved like that. I still miss her every day.